Somebody tilt you?
Nobody can stand straight against this wind.
It's not blowing in here.
Get the tummy so sudden?
Come on, scrape yourself up and get going with those letters. They all want pictures. And you better get some more made. We're running low.
We won't need them. I had some new ones made of me. Look.
Good likeness, huh?
Yeah, too good.
Hey, send them the skipper's mug. Boy, I don't know what that guy's got, but I could sure use some of it.
Spock, you know I had that nightmare again last night? You know the one where the skipper finds out we're using his picture and his name to promote this loot?
You and your dreams. He's up in 2.5 years, has he? He isn't going to as long as you sort the mails, is he? Hey, we got an Albert O'Neill in our files.
Albert O'Neill, just a second. Olson, Olvera, O'Neill. We got a Margaret O'Neill, no Alberta.
Here's her note, Lister. Raisin cookies. Good, too.
O'Neill, Alberta.
Hi. All right, all right. Quit dragging your anchor. Use 2 fingers.
What's the hurry? The next balloon doesn't leave till tomorrow.
Listen, by the time you finish typing a weather report, it ain't news, it's history. You boys all set for the show tonight? Head out of shape. No muscle. All flab. Why, just this morning, I was looking at my little notebook. The one that tells me you two AC-Ducey losers owe me exactly $384.49. And I said to myself, now what these two boys need is some good, healthy exercise. Like moving that pile of ballast rock from the north end of the island to the south end.
But Mike, you don't understand.
No, we're in fine shape. We're strong.
Yeah, I'll believe that when you prove it, by lifting that debt.
Come in.
Morning, sir. Here's the report.
Thanks, Mike.
32 months, I keep weather that never changes. What a career.
Join the Navy and the world.
Yeah, but so little for so long.
Well, maybe the show will give our morale a lift. How's it lining up?
Oh, terrific. Olson and Sally are going to do a ukulele duet. Real Hawaiian stuff. Luders is going to do his magic act, and Grogan and Riley are going to... I want to top it off with five or six solos. It'll be a whale of a show.
Well, Sparks and Solly will probably make up for it. They have worked up some new numbers, huh?
Well, they've been pretty busy, sir, and...
You better give them some time off to rehearse.
Very well, sir. I'll take care of it.
You sure were right, Mike. We're really out of shape.
All right, we'll pick up.
Yeah, well, forget the rock pile and work on your act for the show.
Oh, come Mike, on, you can't do that.
You're volunteering to do this show. And that's an order.
Rocked in the cradle of the deep, I lay me down in peace. Secure, I rest upon the wave.
Ah, cut it out, will you, Chief?
For thou, O Lord, power to save. But oh, that thou not slight my call.
Go into your
den. For thou dost mark the sparrow's fall.
That concludes Chief Donovan's act, for which we're certainly thankful. And now for our grand finale, brought to Montefiore at great expense, our super deluxe attraction, Maestro, Strike Up the Band.
Thank you.
second, fellas. Come on, Sully.
Come on, come on. Come on. We've got to go. Come on.
Sparks and Sully merchandise might is open for business. Each and every item knit, hooked, baked, or crocheted by the loving hands of a beautiful babe.
Here you are, pecan pie from a Peach Tree Pepperoo.
$4.50.
Show me that beautiful shaggy sweater from a Salt Lake City sweetie.
This is a sweater?
The old man raised the sheep himself. Cookies from a Cucamonga cutie. You pay your money and you take your choice.
All right. Break it up. You swabbies ain't got nothing else to do. I'll dream up a few special details for you.
Hey, what goes? You want to be sued for restraint of trade?
You know what? I'm going to keep right on restraining till you two pikers pay me off. $384.49.
But our money's bank stateside, you know that.
We'll give you a check.
Cash.
That's impossible with the store closed. You'll have to let us open.
I don't have to do nothing. But you two better raise that dough. And this sucker trap stays closed till you do it.
But, Mike...
Get going to your radio. You're taking the night trick.
It's Rusty's turn tonight.
You! Rusty applauded my solo. On your way, Coden ahead.
Stinker.
And as for you...
I'm off duty. Skipper's orders. Now listen, Mike. Why don't you take some of that AC-Doocy dough out and trade? These socks are just about your size.
A fin for those signal flags? I'll give you a buck for the lot.
The price is $5 a pair.
$5? Not with Cleopatra's gams in them. What's that crud?
Crud? Assorted fudge.
Pretty fair, but not as good as my girl's. Beulah puts olives and little white onions in hers.
Beulah?
Yeah, Gila Grimes, my girlfriend. Did you say something?
No.
Here, let me try one of these.
Oh, you wouldn't like those.
Oh, yes, I would. This is my payoff for not telling the skipper about you two guys running this deadfall on Navy time. Olives. Onions!
Skipper, then take over the key. I'll be back in a minute.
It was another girl's tenant. Honest! Lots of girls make fudge with olives and onions. Might have a heart.
I'm going to. Yours. Let me out. Let me get my hands on him.
Another girl's tenant, Albert O'Neill. We don't even know a Beulah.
That's the truth.
Well, maybe, but olives and onions both.
What girl would look at us when they could have you?
Well, yeah, that figures.
Sully, we're quitting business. We've had nothing but trouble from this store.
Wait a minute, Sparks, you can't do that.
Oh, yes, I can. We try to do something decent. Share our surplus with our friends. All they do is kick about prices. Anybody else would have doubled them, tripled them, multiplied by 10. True friendship means more than filthy money. We're going to peddle this deal to some louse who'll really hike the prices and show these stinkers around here how fair we've been. Sully... Round up the men. We're selling to the highest bidder. Right.
Oh, now, wait a minute. There's no need to take the men away from their duties. Now, if you want to sell, why, maybe I'll buy you out.
Tear up the IOUs?
Sure, you can tear them up. What do you say to $50?
Oh, I'd say 100.
150.
Do I hear 175?
175.
180.
190. How much do you weigh, Mike?
About 200.
250.
275.
300.
350.
360. How much you got there, Mike?
About 375.
Sold!
But 375 to the man with the day's look. That's mine.
Ah, don't get grabby. Don't get grabby. I want a bill of sale.
Bill of sale.
Bill of sale. Here we go.
Come on, right, I'll do the bill. It's the paper. Here you are, Mike. Official and legal.
I'm glad Mike got the place. Nobody else could handle it.
And here's yours.
IOUs? You said cash.
You said we could tear these up.
Go ahead. Start tearing. And now, unless there's something you'd like to buy for cash, Get out of my store!
But we've got all
my gear in our
store hours.
After store hours.
Get
out of here. Go on.
Hey, Chief, the skipper wants to see you.
The skipper, eh?
On the double.
Okay.
Honey, in just 2 weeks, you better be there, too. Come in.
You sent for me, sir?
I sure did. Mike, we're going home.
Home?
Yep. Relief unit arrives in the morning. Orders came by radio 15 minutes ago. Say, why don't you get the men started packing? This is one ship we don't want to miss.
My radio 15 minutes ago. And they sold me.
Sparks! Solly! Front and center!
Sully, speak to me.
Bring up the linebackers. They're coming through tackle.
Sully, get up. Come on, get up. We gotta pack.
The cinch, none of this stuff is worth packing.
As long as we got our records, we can set up business any place we land. Get the treasure.
Good old Fort Knox. It's a good thing we're leaving. Another 6 months here and we'd be in the high tax bracket.
Put your pocket lettuce in there.
Okay. Hey, why are we putting all our eggs just in one basket? Suppose gentleman pulls a duffel bag inspection.
He's a cinch to musclehead. That's why we're sending this stuff with the office supplies. Come on.
Is the skipper's stuff all packed?
Al and Jim are taking care of it.
Well, give him a hand. Give him a hand. Hey, wait a minute. All that stuff in the same locker.
There isn't any room, Chief.
We'll make room.
Give me the big one.
Yeah, give me the little one.
All square secure, Chief.
Okay. 24M326 are on this one, Red. And YS on the yeoman supply.
Everybody gets a pleasure cruise. We spend our time manicuring a transport.
Yeah, wearing ourselves out. Working our heads to the bone.
Want some suntan lotion?
No, I'm loaded. When I think of the way that Donovan is making that slave on board this boy... I fear I'm deep, la, 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 la.
It's you two rats that are going to be trapped. And you're going to stay on this detail for the rest of the trip.
Connors, Johnson. What's all this?
Chief Donovan's orders, sir.
May we get back to work, sir? Gotta get it done, sir.
Donovan?
Aye, aye, sir.
Donovan, this is a Navy transport, not a slave galley. You're a CPO, not Captain Bly. Can you keep that in mind?
Aye, aye, sir.
Carry on.
Your chisel, Mr. Donovan.
And your brush, Mr. Chiseler.
California in the morning.
Yeah, well, don't start enjoying it until we get there. Donovan will be looking for us.
Oh, don't worry about him. I found a place for us to hide out. Down this way. Come on.
Hiya, Mike.
Hey, wait a minute. Come here, come here. What are you so happy about? Figure a way to peddle a hot battleship?
No, we were just thinking about how much we're going to miss you when we get reassigned.
Oh, well, now, don't burst into tears. We'll be together for a while. Until the bank's open and you pay off those IOUs.
Oh, sure, sure.
Well, I even know some guys low enough that would try to make a quick break for it once we reach shore. Running away before they pay their debts.
Not really.
Why, I wouldn't believe it.
Well, me either. Detail. Ten. Right. Face. Right. Face. Right. You remember that locker that had the weather reports in it? We'll get it out from under the tarp.
Just get it out?
Yeah, and put the tarp back when you're through. No, not this one. That one.
I don't suppose you would know just where in the pile it would be.
Sure, I know. And after you've dug it out, you'll know too. Now get with it! Nice going, boys. Very nice going. Now you can put everything back the way it was.
Oh, Mike, have a heart.
And after that, you'll guard this thing till it's turned over to the port office.
That junk?
That bunch of old weather reports.
Official orders, boys. Official orders. All 24M, 326 lockers are to be given special security. Meaning you two. And with you anchored to this, I'll know just exactly where you are when the bank's open.
Tell me something, Mike. How do you get your pants on over your rattles?
All right, you two. Get with it. Get with it. Your teeth.
Don't let him bluff you. Push him out of the way.
Him? We gotta get off ahead of Donovan.
Okay. You lead with your teeth.
Gangway! Official documents! Gangway, boy! Gangway
official papers coming through.
Gangway, official documents.
That's the stuff. Gangway, boy!
Wait a minute, some of these bays must be unattached.
We ain't got time for that now. Come on.
You watch the locker.
You watch it. I'm lonesomer than you.
Oh, good idea.
Why waste time looking, baby? I'm here.
But if you prefer single men, I'm here.
Sorry, gentlemen, but I prefer my fiancé. Do you know if Lieutenant Smith's come ashore yet? Lieutenant Steve Smith?
You must be our skipper's girlfriend, Betty Lou.
Uh-huh. Oh, there he comes. Steve! Stevie! Stevie! Stevie!
The candy makers.
The cookie bakers.
Nobody home. Hey, how about some service?
Let's dump it and run.
What, without getting it signed off?
Anything I can do for you?
I never had so many answers to one question.
My friends call me Salty, but you can call me Darling.
My friends call me Mrs. Riley. My husband's a 200-pound Marine.
You can call me Salty.
Now, what did you want?
I'd like an envelope and a receipt, please.
All right, the envelope part's easy.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. What's the receipt for?
That locker over there.
All right.
Will you give this to Lieutenant Smith when he comes in, please?
Mm-hmm, surely. What's the classification number of that locker?
24M326.
Oh, wait a minute. You can't leave that here. Not a 326. We've just had a new directive on those. Just a minute. Hey, wait a minute, you two. I can't accept that.
You already have, baby.
Well, come back here.
What are you two doing here?
Delivering that locker as ordered, sir.
I've already told him I can't accept it.
Stand by.
But, sir.
Stand by. Lieutenant Smith, Mona Falou detail reporting.
I'll tell the commander, sir.
Sir, a young lady on the pier gave us something to give to you. It's in that envelope on the desk.
Lieutenant Smith, the man responsible for that near riot at my pier?
Well, not responsible, Commander. Those women were all strangers to me.
Not from what I heard?
On my honor, sir, my fiancée was on that pier. She returned this and ran away. If you'll just sign off my paper so I can find her, talk to her.
Looks to me as if you've been made the victim of a practical joke, Lieutenant. Use that phone if you wish.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Naughty, naughty.
I bet her maiden name was Donovan. You know, I haven't played one of these in years.
Hello, is Betty there? Oh, this is Lieutenant Smith calling.
How dare you call my daughter? I've forbidden her to see you. Speak of you. Think of
you. Yes, sir.
Navy men are all alike. Love pirates. Two
well,
divers.
You see, sir, I didn't...
Eyes on you and break you in two. Nothing
no,
but a
cat. No, I...
The lady seemed a bit upset.
That was her father. He doesn't approve of Navy men.
Oh, he doesn't, eh?
No, sir. He was in the Army, artillery captain, 1918.
An Army man? Forget her, Lieutenant. Forget her.
But I can't, sir. We're in love. And he isn't in the Army now. He's a senator, Senator Prentice.
Prentice, huh? Senator Prentice.
Prentice? The head of the Budget Expenditure Committee? The one who's out here now on an inspection tour?
Yes, sir.
You know what that old nickel nurse is up to. He's trying to cut down the Navy. Our Navy. To an old leaky rowboat. He's scuttling the fleet.
Lieutenant, you've got to make up with this man. And his daughter, too, for the good of the service.
Well, I'm willing, sir, but how?
Huh? Will you, I...
You're a woman. If you were that girl, what kind of a lie would you fall for?
Well...
Come on, we're wasting time.
Well, I suppose if it really was a practical joke and the man that arranged it confessed it to me...
There you are, Lieutenant. Find the funny man. Drag him to her.
I have no idea who it was.
Then we'll get a volunteer to play his part. One of your fellow officers.
But I don't know where they are.
Then we'll use an enlisted man. One of these two.
Well, why not both? Then they can back up each other's stories.
I'm afraid we wouldn't be very good at it, sir. Lying doesn't come natural to us.
You refuse to volunteer?
Oh, no, sir. No, we'd be glad to do it, sir.
Here's my keys. Take my car. It's right outside.
Thanks a million, sir.
I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing it for the Navy.
Yes, sir.
Well, don't let those men go, sir. Who's going to guard the locker?
You got it.
Sir, I...
Sit on it. That's an order.
Follow that car. Comrade Peter, лавочки коробочки.
Гармонии гравать всех любить, дай.
Betty! Betty Lou!
Young man, why don't you watch where you're going?
Wait! Bert, Solly, come on! Hold it, bud.
Here you are, Lee.
Oh, thank you.
Just a moment. Dorman.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, please.
Say,
this is a very fine piece of cloth.
Thank you.
You see, I'm a newspaper reporter. Tell me, what happened here?
Sonia, a propagolna krapasa se kislumich another nickel. Ush, capitalistic trap. That Ivan, with him every errand is another five-year plan.
Did you find him?
Shh. Yeah. Sonia, you're absolutely right. It is a matter of great importance.
Where is he now? What's he doing?
Everything is all confusion. Much excitement. But by my clever questioning, by my very clever questioning, I straightened it out.
You did?
Shh. Now listen. The lieutenant arrives at the hotel. Right away, checks out on the big Lord Senator Prentice, the commissar of the expenditure committee.
Oh, no.
Shh. The lieutenant follows him. Now, from a desk clerk, I learn that the senator's mail is being forwarded to Washington.
Well?
We lost them.
Maybe if we kept driving and looking, sir.
No. We're going back to the hotel, find that woman, and learn who put her up to calling me Stevie.
Oh, I've got a better idea, sir. Maybe Navy Brass knows the next stop on the senator's tour. If we hurry back to the base...
That's a good idea.
That's right, Senator Prentice. Where is he going, and when, and on what? What? Well, hurry it up, will you?
Doesn't intelligence know where he went?
Oh, yes. They finally found out that they know. Now they're checking to see if the information is restricted.
That's the last of the Liberty passes, sir. I'll take care of the rest of your paperwork for you.
Thanks, Mike.
Just a minute, sonny boy. I'll take care of these.
Yes. No, I don't want it in triplicate. I haven't time to wait for a messenger. Give it to me over the phone. Certainly, I'll take the responsibility. Yeah? Huh? Thank you. Thank you with carbon copies. Washington, on the limited, leaves in an hour. Riley, where are you?
Yes, sir.
Get transportation on the limited from Lieutenant Smith. Make all his expense vouchers, travel orders. Special duty, my orders.
Oh, but you can't do that, sir.
Who the star-spangled barnacle foul captain says I can't?
General Order 57 DXY, sir. All officers with classification K-17R must remain at Fort Reassignment through SINPAC.
But Special Directive 1612 gives port officers the authority to countermand that.
Yes, sir. But Subinterpretation X-19Y, Paragraph C, cancel that.
But Special Emergency Bulletin 92YD reinstates it.
Only on the Atlantic seaboard, sir. That's added bulletin 149X4.
Someday, I'm going to out-directive you. You little red tapeworm, you!
Yes, sir.
Orders or no orders, I'm going to be on that train.
Now, I know how you feel, but...
Well, sir, I found this locker directive.
At this time, you dare to bring that up, why?
Well, I think you'll find it the answer. Listen. All 24 M326 lockers to be immediately forwarded to Navy Meteorological Headquarters under Class 2 security. You can assign Lieutenant Smith to deliver this one, and Navy Meteorological Headquarters...
Or in Washington.
Baby!
Release that woman. Now go get your personal duffel.
Yes, sir.
Call up transport. Order up a truck.
Call the pool, get transport detail. Call the railroad. Never mind, I'll call the railroad myself. What's that phone number?
What's the railroad phone number?
I tell you, you put it in here with your own hand.
What's the matter, hotshot? You missing something?
Just a small cardboard carton.
Oh, that. Me and Al had to switch it to make room. They're in the other locker with the weather reports.
In the other locker?
The 326.
All our papers.
All our savings.
Come on.
Well, where's the truck? Where's the transport detail? What's holding things up around here?
The truck's on its way, sir, and the pool's sending over two enlisted men, but there aren't any unassigned petty officers on the base. They're trying to reach one now by phone.
Well, we haven't got time for that. We'll have to... Go get your pajamas, Chief. You're going for a train ride.
Aye, aye, sir.
Well, don't sit there, Larry. Come in and I'll dictate those travel orders.
Oh, but, sir, the locker.
The what?
Nothing, sir. Oh, just a minute. You boys know where to take that?
We sure do, Missy, ma'am. We sure do.
Who's that?
It's just the men from the pool, sir.
Back up, back up. Take it the other way. Full speed astern, it's Donovan.
Lieutenant Smith? Your transport orders and vouchers, sir.
Thanks. Donovan, where are you going?
With you, sir. I drew this detail.
You ready to roll, Chief?
Well, just as soon as two men show up with the locker.
They're here just a minute ago. Okay, all set? They're inside.
Oh. What does he mean, all set?
Who knows? Let's get out of here. Tell that hot rodder to slow down, will you?
Them off. That's the skipper and Donovan out there. Grab the locker. We'll bail out as soon as they stop.
You guys okay back there?
Sure, and there's nothing but fine we're doing.
Sparks, Solly. You gave up your liberty time to help me?
Yes, sir.
Of course, sir.
Well, I won't forget it, believe me. Gentlemen, give them a hand. I'll get the tickets.
Aye, aye, sir.
So, trying to sneak out on me, huh?
Well, we're all going together, boys. Here. Lifted luggage. Now shove off.
These are yours, gentlemen.
Here.
And here.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Make yourselves comfortable, men. I'll see you later.
Hey, wait a minute. Where do you two think you're going?
To the baggage car, of course. We've got to guard it, and this is baggage.
We'll guard it here.
Well, we don't mind. We like the baggage car.
I like it here.
Now put it over there.
Oh, sorry.
Yes, what is it?
You! What are you doing on this train?
Well, all I want is a chance
you
to...
You stay away from my daughter. You thief. If you dare... And get off of this train.
immediately.
Oh, Stephen.
I beg your pardon. Were you speaking to me?
But of course. Don't you recognize me? Your own little Sonia.
What? My Sonia?
To think that fate had you nuts.
Oh, now, wait a minute, lady. Let's skip the act. Who's the joker who put you up to this?
Stephen, Stevie, darling. How can you be so cruel?
Yes, sir, a very intriguing problem, but not too tough to solve. Hey, what's the skipper fouled up by? A flood of dames. B, who knows the skipper and more dames than anybody else? You two.
Genius. Big brain. Mike Donovan, boy detective. Yeah. And how could we have rigged up this deal from 3,000 miles away? And what would we have gained by lousing up the skipper?
Well, I don't know. But when I do, you're gonna get hit with everything in the book.
I tell you, I never wrote you any letters, and I never received any of yours. You must have me mixed up with another Lieutenant Steve Smith.
One who looks like this?
Well, that's a picture of me, but... What did I say in these letters you claim I wrote?
Oh, Steve.
Well, I mean, besides that.
All about your exciting experiments.
Exciting? Well, all I did was play with balloons. I said one up in the morning and one up in the afternoon.
Now, Steve, dear, you can trust me. I know the truth.
Battleship Bluebeard. Cruiser Casanova. Let me tell you something, young lady. Oh, I'm sorry.
Good afternoon, sir. May I validate your tickets?
Tickets? Oh, they're in my stateroom.
There's an insane Navy officer on this train. I want to throw it off bodily.
Mr. Bois, please. Wait. Betty Lou, honey.
Sir?
There's the man. That's the man right there. I demand you throw that maniac off this train.
Now, wait a minute.
You know, I bet they got cases and cases of ice-cold beer in the club car. And probably lots of lonesome ladies just dying to meet a sailor.
Go ahead. I'm comfortable here.
This whole thing is ridiculous.
I know how you feel, Lieutenant. Now, you sit down and cool off. This railroad has to go through another senatorial investigation.
How'd you make out, Skipper?
I sunk on sight. And I bumped into another dame who called me Stevie.
First call for dinner. First call for dinner.
Well, obviously, the rat knows a lot of women. An awful lot of women.
I'm sure of one thing. The rat was on Mona Falou.
Oh, no, sir.
I think you're mistaken, sir.
Well, she has a photograph of me taken on the island. Solly, I want you to tell me the truth.
Yes, sir.
You had charge of the mail. Who was corresponding with a Miss Dubois?
Well, I wouldn't know that, sir. The men just dropped their letters in the outgoing sack.
Hadn't you better get to the diner?
No, I'm not hungry. Now, look, about that mail, Salty.
But if Betty Lou goes to the diner, you might be able to see her.
Betty Lou? Yeah, that's a good idea. Thanks.
Go feed your face, Chief. We'll eat later.
Some rat on Mona Falou, eh? Some pair of rats who are obviously writing to all those dames. Ha!
He can't prove nothing. Not unless he finds what's in the locker.
Goodbye.
So long.
Salty! Get back in here! Are you crazy?
Just cowardly. When the skipper sees that stuff...
He won't if we get to it first. And besides that, it's all your fault.
My fault?
Yeah, your fault. You shouldn't have let me talk you into it in the first place.
Nothing at all.
What kind of nothing at all?
Sit down and be quiet, Buster.
My name ain't Buster, it's Bertram. Why are you trying to pick that lock?
Listen, you little...
Ow! When my mom gets back, I'm gonna tell her
that
you...
What we're gonna do? We're gonna play games.
I don't like games.
But we're gonna play hide and seek. You hide.
Yeah.
How about puss in the corner? We get him in the corner and sock his ugly...
Shut up. Would you sit down and be a good boy if I gave you that?
Trying to bribe me, huh? Okay. What you trying to rob out of the box?
You said you'd get down and be good.
I am down and I am good. What's in your old box anyhow?
Little boys, nosy little boys who ask too many questions. Yeah, all cut up in little pieces, heads and arms and legs.
Help! Help!
We're only kidding, Bertie.
Yeah, there are no little boys in there at all.
What is in it?
Candy. Yeah, peppermints and chocolate and licorice and all kinds of creams.
Oh, boy!
If you want the candy, you're gonna stay right there.
Okay.
There must be a hacksaw or something somewhere on this train.
Yeah.
I'll go that way. You go this way. He's our pal. Go on, pal. Open the nice box again.
I will not. I don't want no old papers.
You open that box or I'll chirp me. But the candy's under the papers, Bertie, hidden away.
You're making that up.
Bertie, once again, I'll get you all the candy you can eat. Later.
I want to get it now!
Can't. Our officer, he won't let us give candy away. Hiya, sir. Have a good dinner?
13 cups of coffee. Then I find out Betty Lou had dinner in her stateroom. Sit down, boys.
Stiff joint, sir. Feels better this way.
Too bad you didn't get a chance to see her, sir.
Well, the time wasn't entirely wasted. Donovan had some theories in the letter deal. You see, if all those crazy females...
I just got an idea. Soldy and I'll get your girl and fix up everything.
Now, wait a minute. Her father wouldn't allow a Navy uniform within a mile of her. Now, as I was saying...
I got a way around the old man. Excuse me, sir.
Well, hi, cowboy.
You varmint.
Okay, now what's the big idea that gets us? Skipper's petunia. None. The big idea was to duck that year in the brig question. So we ducked it. Now what do we do? Cut our throats? Nah, we have to figure out a way of getting into that locker.
The skipper just took a walk. We could chop our way in.
Shh. Hey, I bet he'd move if we told him Betty Lou was waiting for him. Say, in the club car. And when she wasn't.
Yeah, we should have brought our civvies. We could maybe get to her wearing those.
My dear.
Thanks.
Yes, dear.
Gene. Gene Hensley, how are you? When'd you get out of the Navy?
Well, you made a mistake. My name's Purcell.
Why the alias? Hiding from shore patrol?
No. My name is Purcell.
Then what's the idea of going around pretending to be Gene? Shame on you! It'll sure feel good to get into civvies for a change.
On that kid.
You just give me those uniforms, gentlemen. I'll have the valet clean them good as new.
Come on, get over. Well, what are you going to do, make the whole trip with your nose in that magazine?
No, dear, but you were talking to those ladies.
Oh, those poor dears. Their husbands didn't want to bring them along either. What did you do with my suitcase?
I put it back at this seat.
Hey, Sully.
Yeah, the way this administration spends money. $2 billion here, $3 billion there. I'll tell you, it all adds up.
Pardon us. We're looking for Miss Betty Lou Prentice.
We understand she's on this train, and we're very great friends of a friend of hers.
There you are, my dear. Helen would never forgive us for not giving you her deepest love.
And you must be Senator Prentice.
Yes, that's right.
Steve sent us. Play it up, kid. Play it up.
I'm Mabel Mansfield, and this is my sister, Myrtle. Surely Helen has told you about us.
Oh, yes, of course. How is she?
Ghastly, my dear. She's in the most fascinating operation.
Four surgeons cutting and slicing, my dear. They took out her. Oh, I forgot there was a man in the room.
Why don't you toddle along to the club car and get a drinky-drinky while we girls have a little chit-chat?
You'll let me order drinks for all of us. There's nothing like a tall one to make a long trip a short one.
Oh, God! Oh, you're a cute one, you are.
I'll be right back.
Honey, you've got Steve all wrong. He doesn't know any of those women. He's been framed.
Order a lemonade for my daughter and three double zombies, please. Hurry it up.
He's just the victim of a practical joker. He's so heartbroken. So cut up.
So cut from here to here. And the first surgeon said... And they did!
Oh, poor Helen. Back already, Daddy.
I sent the porter. You live in the East, Miss Mabel?
No. I just flit from here to there. Baltimore, Bremerton, San Diego. Life's just one big mad world.
Let's
see. Oh, my goodness.
Whatever is the matter, Mabel?
My purse. I think I've left it in the Pullman car.
With all our money in it?
Oh, I'm afraid to go back to look. If it's gone, I'll simply die.
Now, don't you worry, my dear. I'll go for you.
Oh, thank you, Senator. It's about this big, black, just a couple of cars in the rear.
I'll get it in a jiffy.
How about it, kid? Will you give the skipper a break?
Yeah, before he does something desperate.
I do want to be fair.
Now, you're talking. Come on.
Oh, just a minute. I'd like to fix my makeup.
Will you stay here and stall Papa? I'll get into my uniform and send the skipper to the club car.
Whoa, wait a minute, lady. Get out.
This is the gentleman's room, ma'am. You can't come here.
I just want to get my plan.
The ladies' dressing room, ma'am, is at the other end of the car.
It's a shame. What a woman won't do to get a man these days.
There. Do I look all right?
Honey, if you weren't half hitched to my skipper. Well, come on.
What's wrong?
Your old man with somebody's purse.
Here I am, Mabel. See?
Thank you very much, but you can't come in now.
Oh.
Mabel's sick. Yes, train sick.
Oh, the poor dear. Is there something I can do for her?
Well, maybe a short snort would help her.
Oh, a short... I have a flask in my bag. I'll get it. Here you are.
Thank you.
Oh, can't I come in and stroke her forehead?
No. We had to loosen her garments.
Oh.
You stay in your stateroom, and I'll call you when she snaps out of it.
All right.
Well, I get back to that voice pointers. I pay for exclusive models of the women on the trains wearing the same thing.
Sorry, mister, I have a cat. Oh, it's you. Say, did you get the skipper away from the locker?
Yeah, he's gone to meet Betty Lou. But Donovan has his big dogs parked on it now.
Say, get my uniform, will you?
Okay, wait right here.
Don't worry, ma'am. If your suitcase is on this train, we'll find it.
Listen, all my new dresses were in it. My black captor, my dotted navy blue, and my new suit. 10 minutes later, my purse was stolen.
Let me help you. Did you hurt yourself?
No, I'm all right. Thank you very much.
Sit down, sweetie.
No, thank you.
What happened to the young lady?
Well, I think she tripped.
Come,
darling, put your head on my shoulder.
No, thank you. I'm perfectly all right.
Why don't you take to the club?
Come on, baby. Come with Uncle
Mike. Don't worry, man. Your suitcase is on this train.
You get to bed. And the person got right on there without anything taken. Mom, out from under.
Oh, Steve, you'll never get away from me again.
Is that a promise? Here. You put this on, and don't take it off again, huh?
I promise.
Donovan!
Oh, yes, sir.
Donovan, if Betty Lou and I got off the train, you could deliver the locker, couldn't you?
Oh, yes, sir. Is that all, sir?
Yes, for the moment.
Aye, aye, sir.
Myrtle? Myrtle?
But you don't find it. I'll bet that that railroad is going to hear from me, and I'm going to hold them absolutely responsible.
Excuse. No sign of it here, ma'am.
There's my purse.
Oh, you're mistaken, madam. This belongs to my lady friend.
Where is she?
Well, she was here just a minute ago. I don't know where she went.
Oh, that's a likely story. Give me that purse,
well,
you
wait
see.
Just a minute here.
Oh,
give
you
the lady your purse. You're a disgrace to the uniform. Shame on you.
The Donovan one is in the club car. The lieutenant is in the vestibule with the girl. Sparks is with the locker. Now the other vanished.
Vanished? So childish is Americans. Imagine a lieutenant trying to deny having written to me.
Oh, obviously under orders to talk to no one.
Obviously.
Of course. And then that silly story about spending months in South Pacific. Sending balloons. Well, there are more ways than one to skin a cat. Comrades?
Comrade Ivan, I don't understand. She had two mean coats. What does she want with the skin of a cat?
Comrade Peter, in America, agrakapulshnik,
travalnyy gromadzhan, is a
mean coat.
Hello.
Hello.
You are traveling with Lieutenant Smith?
Yeah, yeah.
A friend of mine. Do you mind if I sit here?
Do I mind? Not at all.
But we both saw the lady come out here.
Oh, I suppose she just disappeared into thin air.
Well, it's got me baffled.
Look, conductor, I'll guarantee Chief Donovan's appearance whenever you want him. Will that satisfy you?
Well, I guess so. The lady's got her purse bag.
That's not my suitcase. Where did his vanishing lady friend hide that?
Well, we'll search the train again.
And he wrote all about his fascinating work. So secret. So, dangerous.
Yes, I know. And Steve and I worked as a team with all that stuff.
You did?
Yeah. Of course, I wouldn't let him take any of the big risks. You should see the documents we got in here.
Oh?
Yes, Steve and I are personally guarding them all the way to Washington. So you figure it out from there.
I'd so love to hear more of your wonderful adventures. Perhaps you could come to my stateroom later?
What's the matter with right now?
There are certain complications. I'll let you know when we won't be disturbed.
You try riding that route for an hour or so. Where's my uniform?
Right there.
Why, Myrtle?
Well, there you are. The skipper wants to see you. Come on.
Now's your chance. Go crack that locker.
One called Salty is guarding it. The others are in the club car.
Good. Now we all know our moves. Comrades? Hello.
Hello.
Are you a friend of the sailor named Sparks?
Yeah.
Do you mind?
Are you kidding?
I was wondering what became of him. He promised to come to my stateroom, tell me of his adventures in the Pacific.
His adventures? Compared to me, that kid never left home.
Oh?
By the way, what did you say your stateroom number was?
Stateroom B, car 34.
Check. I'll be there as soon as I can get somebody to watch this thing.
I'll be waiting.
Well, there you are, Mike. You got it straight now.
Yes, sir. I clear the purse business with the railway detectives in Chicago and take the locker on to Washington.
Right. And if we can make plane connections, we'll be there to meet you.
Well, happy eloping, sir.
Oh, thanks, Sparks. And tell Soli I appreciate his help, too.
Yes, sir.
I better get out to the vestibule.
Good luck, Skipper.
Thanks.
You are Mr. Johnson?
Yeah.
There's a certain lady waiting for you in stateroom B. Car 34.
Sparks, old buddy.
Out of my way, bud.
Sparks, old pal. Come back here, please.
Oh. Mr. Jensen, how prompt you are.
Not me, gorgeous. I'm late. 2 years and 8 months overdue.
If his lady friend was a thief, how does it happen that my suitcase turned up in the men's washroom? Thank you. I've had so many things happen to me on a trip in my life. There's something going on around here that I don't understand. I don't know what it is, but I'll find out before the trip's over.
Pardon me, ma'am. Would you keep an eye on that locker until one of my shipmates shows up?
Well, yes, I guess so.
Thank you. When the Pacific moon was shining, and the wind was rustling those palm trees, Do you know what I was dreaming about?
Yes, yes, yes. Let's get back to those guided missiles.
Well, one radio beam goes out like this. Another beam goes out like this. And when they make contact...
Good heavens, my husband. Quick, in there. Well, Mr. Connors, how prompt you are.
Let's not waste time talking, baby.
You know, I have this address right here in my... Where will I put my purse there? Conductor, someone has stolen my purse.
Oh, did you look all over?
There's my purse under that man's chair. That is my purse.
Oh, no, not again.
Take your old hand, Dag.
Promised. Now about your adventures.
That's in the past, baby. We're working on the future.
My husband, quick, in there.
I didn't know you were her husband.
Well, then complain to the police. I'm locking you up in a baggage car.
Get the ladder. Hurry.
Well, was he?
Sonia! Louder. Her husband might be hard of hearing. Goodbye. Excuse me, bud.
What? Mabel, are you awake?
I told the sailor boy I'd watch it, and I've just been sitting here with Bertie. Now, where did that boy go?
Ivan, Peter, look.
Agrikopolnik Lauski. Krabodilnik.
Bertram? Bertram! Come back here!
Quick, take it away.
Hey, Solly, Sparse, get the skipper.
Keep going.
Looks like the chief's in trouble.
Sure does.
Hey, it's gone. And there it goes. Hey, that's ours.
I tell you, you're making
out of the way. Out of the way.
Anyway.
Hey, wait a minute. But they owe me money. Stop that man.
Oh, pardon me, sir.
That man, where'd he go?
Out there.
You're responsible, so I'm holding you.
Well, you can't. I'm eloping. Wait a minute. I'll get him for you. Darren! Darren! Hold
on! Well?
Well!
Darren!
Naval.
Betty Lou. Betty Lou. Conductor, hold that train. Don't you dare let it leave this station. Betty Lou. Betty Lou.
Hold the train. Don't let it leave the station.
Minsk.
Minsk.
Welcome, comrade.
The two men get here. Two men with the locker.
Da. Boy John.
Sonia, are you sure you weren't followed?
Quite sure.
We were by those sailors. I think we lost them about a mile back. Ivan, back to the window. Please keep watching.
Did it hold all we hoped for?
We don't know it. The whole thing is in code.
Da. Made to look like weather reports. Hundreds of weather reports. We test for secret ink. We use black light. Also the new cipher pattern. But don't worry, we will decode them.
Code, schmode, I still think it's nothing but identical weather reports. Which only proves that they are a code. Why else would they send this stuff to Washington under guard? Washington, D.C.
Donovan!
Here you are.
Well, you've led me a fine chase. You fouled up my elopement, ruined my wedding. I'll have your stripes for this.
Oh, sir, Salty and Sparks went AWOL. I was chasing them.
Salty and Sparks? Are they around here?
Well, somewhere, sir. I lost them in the alley. But they've got to be in this block. Well, I'll tell you. You go around this way, and I'll go around this way, and we're sure to nail them.
Okay, and if they're responsible, they'll spend their next three enlistments in the brig.
Aye, aye, sir.
Igralne Krapuchnist, second line. Come on. Lieutenant Smith is walking down the street. Pack up everything out the back door.
Just a minute. He's the very man we want. He knows the code. Come.
Right. Hey, look. What do you know? It's the skipper.
I wonder why he got off the train. I never knew him to pass out like that.
Me neither. Let's go. Come on, Nekrapas, please!
Trying to be a hero will gain you nothing, Lieutenant.
Start talking. What is the key to this code?
I've told you it isn't in code.
We know what you were doing on Monafalu Island.
And don't say observing weather again.
How do you decipher it?
It isn't a cipher.
This must be it. Hoist me up. Speak up, you capitalistic beak.
But I've told you the truth.
Massage him again.
It's your turn.
It's your turn.
Last time. It's hard work. Lieutenant. Hold still.
You clumsy fool. Now look what you have done.
Ah, this bourgeois, they can't take it.
Next time I'll kill him. And we will never find what we are after.
Leave him be. I will get the experts. Huh?
As you command, comrade.
He's sending two specialists. One number 58 and number 89. They will identify themselves with a password. Nizhny Novgorod.
Ichinovka.
let me down.
O'Donovan!
Hello, Miss Prentice.
Have you seen Steve around here?
Oh, yes, sir. He's going around the block that way, and I'm going around the block this way. The only thing is, I've been around five times, and I keep missing him.
He's probably hiding with that woman he's been chasing.
Woman? Oh, no. We're after two sailors that have gone AWOL. Not no dames.
You are?
Sure.
Oh, Donovan, I love you.
Minsk.
Nizhny Novgorod.
Enter, comrades.
Where is the enemy of the proletariat?
Back there.
Out from the way, peasant. Aha! So you are the stubborn one.
No. Waste one in a chair.
Pardon me, but you do look like a traitor. Number 89, get to work. The rest of you, out from the room. Scram, scram, out. Out from the room.
Take it easy, Skipper. We'll get you loose.
Nice going.
This victim, he needs special treatment, proper equipment. Bring car to front door. We take him to laboratory. We take trunk, too.
I hope they hurry. This thing itches.
Psst.
Arcadis. Is it all there?
I don't know.
One, two. He can't jam it now.
Hey. What's all this?
Oh, it's nothing, what? Sir. Nothing,
nothing
at all.
Nothing important. Wait a minute. Women's names. Letters with my signature. Pictures of me. Why, you two no good double crossing.
Sir, we didn't mean any harm.
Come here.
Ain't fun.
Come here.
Sir, I tell you, we didn't mean any harm. All we were doing.
I'll do some come about you.
Dory, come here! Boy! Let me get my hands on that proletariat enemy. Bells, hell, why do you interrupt us?
The car, she's ready.
They tie up his hands again. I look for the cipher.
Well, I get you two out of here.
Let's get in the car. We waste time. You bring the trunk.
Well?
Nizhny Novgorod?
Nizhny Novgorod. Comrade Peter. Prasadim. Prastalidze, good day, Nizhny Novgorod.
Nizhny Novgorod?
Da.
Here it comes, Skipper. Battle stations.
Kapuchnik, Lech!
There's my daughter. Get her.
with the beard?
Yeah, he went over there.
Senator, just about the bravest and cleverest thing a man ever did for his country.
You see, Lieutenant Smith heard that enemy agents were getting information from our Navy men. So, he decided to lay a trap.
And when this caviar cutie fell into it, he saw a chance to nab the whole spy ring.
And we only helped him just a little bit.
He's the real hero.
Boy, I'm proud of you. Your country's proud of you.
And I'm in love with you.
I'm